as you reflect back on where you've been to where you are now, including the events from Tuesday night, does it almost seem as if you've lived multiple lives?
You know, that's a great question, and I think that pretty much sums it up. You know, it's first of all, it was just this feeling just overwhelmed in that moment. Taking a look back at, you know, my life and the things that I've been through, and I think that what President Trump did on that day had given me this sort of a validation that, you know, things have come full circle.
For the contingent of people out there who may look at your situation and say, once a criminal, always a criminal, how would you respond to that?
You know what? I think that all people have the, you know, the ability to change if you work hard. And I'm just hoping that, you know, my life story can serve as a testament, again, from where I have come from, being addicted to everything known to man, criminal behavior, went to prison. God transformed my life, and I've been out in the community, you know, for 11 years. So if I can do it, other people can certainly do it too.
A big part of that change for you has been the creation of Prisoners of Hope. Tell us more about your nonprofit and how that has not only changed your life, but the lives of people who may have found themselves in similar situations to what you were in.
Absolutely. So Hope for Prisons, I tell everyone, was a vision that God had impregnated me with when I was in prison. Worked very hard in putting those things together. Came home in 2009 and started putting it together. So we work with men, women, young adults that are exiting different arenas of our judicial system to provide supportive services to help men and women not only get acclimated back into workplaces, but we address the needs for them to get reintegrated back with their family and ultimately help them to be stand-up leaders inside the community. So I had a chance to work with over 3,400 individuals to help to be able to, them to transform their life and never go back to the prison system again. And that is a gigantic pay value for us in the work that we do for at Hope for Prisons, and what a huge impact it has had on society.
Incredible. There is also a contingent of people out there who feel that the pardoning that took place the other evening should not have taken place in the arena in which it did. Your response to that?
You know, what other arena could have taken place in? Let me first tell you that, because I've heard this a couple of days, and my response is that this is a huge monumental moment for me and my family, and I hope that people don't politicize that. So what I would hope that people would see when they take a look at that, particularly our formerly incarcerated men and women who are out in the community working hard, I hope that that would serve them as an instrument of hope, that they can see that and understand that, because it happened to me, that, you know, we live in a land, a nation of second chances. And because that did happen to me, you know, it could happen to them as well.
Do you feel like you may be a political chess piece in this whole thing, considering you'd been pardoned previously?
Right. I'm not even going to look at it that way. I can tell you that, you know, I have worked very closely with the White House, had conversations about the First Step Act and the criminal justice reform. It wasn't something that was decided in this moment because, you know, there's an election that's coming out. But again, I don't want to focus on that. This is an incredible moment for me. And again, for the other formerly incarcerated people that are out in the community working hard, just want to let that serve as a reference point for them too. If they work hard, can continue to find ways to give back to the community, and one day it may very well happen to them.
Is it safe to assume President Trump has your vote in November?
Well, you know, my vote. Let me tell you, my vote. This election that's coming up right now. Is going to be the very first presidential election that I've ever had the privilege of voting in. It's something that's very special to me. I'm so grateful to have the opportunity to participate in one of the greatest privileges that we have as Americans. I can tell you that, the person that I'm going to vote for is someone who lines up with the biblical principles that I stand on, the biblical values that I have, and if if an agenda or the principles of a candidate lines up with the word of God, then that is the candidate that will have my vote.
So what I hear there is your vote is not yet decided.
Yeah, well, that if the principles and values line up with my principle, my biblical principles and values, then that is the candidate that's going to have my vote.
Very good. Jon, thank you so much for your time. Continued success to you and to Prisoners of Hope as well. And may you continue to take advantage of this next chance.